From Uttarkashi, we started our journey towards our base camp, Gangotri. On our way, we stopped for a few hours to explore a small village called Harshil, which is also known as the mini Switzerland of India. Harshil is a village in a valley situated on the bank of the Bhagirathi river at the foot of the mountain that lies at the head of the Vaspa valley. Harshil is connected to the Vaspa valley by several passes, including the Lamkhaga pass. But for us, it was the place where you can get non-veg food. After having some delicious momos, we explored a little bit of this beautiful village. Thank you. Reaching Gangotri, to acclimatize ourselves, we went out for a hike. Our first stop was Suryakund. In mythology, it is said that the rays of the sun first arrive on earth at this pool, and hence this place is known as Suryakund. Tradition relates that Lord Shiva held the powerful goddess Ganga in his locks here. There is a naturally occurring Shivlinga in the pool. In the winter months, when the water level is relatively low, the waterfall can be seen pouring directly onto the Shivlinga. It was indeed a scenic beauty as milky water gushes out of the rocks making loud sound. I had never seen anything like this. Our next stop was Pandav Gufa.
Thank you.
Gufa is 1.5 km hike from Gangotri. This is the place where the Pandavas are believed to have meditated and rested on the way to Kailash. Way back, we visited Gaurikund, which is another waterfall on river Bhagirathi. With the help of a local guide, we found this place and it was a bit risky to reach here, crossing huge boulders. Since the Gangotri temple was closed at that time, we left for our hotel and planned to visit the temple once we came back from the trek.